Hello, this is Eric Bold from the National Weather Service in Oxnard, California. Here is a quick look at the El Niño Southern Oscillation status and predictions for the upcoming 2014 and 15 winter season for Southwest California. We are currently in an El Niño watch. The ocean is reflecting El Niño conditions, but we're still waiting for the atmosphere to respond. It's likely that El Niño will develop by fall. The strength of El Niño, however, this winter remains uncertain. The typical El Niño pattern looks like this. When the warmer ocean water shifts eastward across the subtropical Pacific Ocean, the jet stream taps into moist storm systems enhanced by the warm waters, and these systems then track across the southern sections of the country. More northern latitudes are typically warmer and drier than normal during an El Niño pattern. This is a look at sea level heights from the NASA JSON satellite. The heights correspond with sea surface temperature and give an idea of warm or cold anomalies. The latest image from late August on the right shows a slight increase in temperatures along the equator compared to the late June image on the left. Sea surface temperatures were above average across the eastern equatorial Pacific Ocean during the last 4 weeks. In addition, temperatures remained well above average over the North Pacific, which has changed little since last winter season. Sea temperatures below the surface at a depth of several hundred feet have warmed again across the equatorial Pacific, as depicted by the progression of images from top to bottom. This is a sign that El Niño may be strengthening at this time. A consensus prediction between scientists at the Climate Prediction Center and the International Research Institute at Columbia University shows that the chance of an El Niño this winter has dropped from 80% to 65% since the August update. The latest El Niño model forecasts project many different outcomes as seen by the spaghetti effect shown above. The current reading is below 0.5 degrees on the left, and the range of outcomes keeps the El Niño mainly in a weak to moderate category through next winter. Historically, in Southwest California, we have seen an increase in above normal rainfall during El Niño winters compared with La Niña and ENSO neutral winters. The probability of above normal rainfall during weak and moderate El Niño events ranges from 41% in Santa Maria in the middle pie chart to 53% in Los Angeles on the left. This is based on a total of 17 weak to moderate El Niños since 1950. The important fact to remember is that the odds of a drier than normal winter are just as high as a wetter than normal winter during weak to moderate events. Here is the latest CPC temperature predictions for the January through March 2015 timeframe. There is no significant signal of either above or below normal temperatures for Southwest California. The precipitation prediction for the January through March 2015 timeframe does show Southwest California with an above normal precipitation potential this upcoming winter season. This forecast is based on classic El Niño trends of wetter storms across the southern tier of the country. Here are the conclusions about El Niño this winter. El Niño is likely, but the strength is uncertain at this time. Chances of above normal rainfall increases during an El Niño compared to other years. El Niño does not mean greater storm intensity. Weak to moderate El Niños have resulted in large extremes across Southern California, either dry or wet. An example, for downtown Los Angeles, we had 3.21 inches in the 2006-07 years, versus 37.06 inches in the 2004-05 years. Flooding is typically caused by back-to-back storms any year, whether it's La Niña, El Niño, or neutral conditions. Thank you for watching this presentation. If you have any comments or questions, please contact me. And remember to visit our website for the latest forecast, watches, or warnings.